Let's Hunt is a video series with tactics, weapons, locations, and other useful tips, always around one particular animal. Good to see you, Hunter, and welcome back to Timbergold Trails, the home of Rocky Mountain Elk. We will start here by having a look on the map. So today's hunt is starting down here. I have a tent here. This is a good starting point for grizzly bear, Rocky Mountain Elk, and also wolves. There's a tree stand here. There's also a tower and more tents. So I will likely walk around this route here up, going north, where I have more tents and tree stands. Where we will not find Rocky Mountain Elk spawning is this area here. So you can cross that out pretty much. But otherwise, everything that is below the mountains, you will find the elk on the west side of the river. Alongside the longbow, I will also bring the 8x57 classic rifle. It's a fun rifle. Difficult to shoot. If you look at the reticle, there's no zoom. It's a really old reticle. And it's a bit harder to shoot over longer distances, but it's fun. And I will also bring the 45 long colt with the name Mule, even though you cannot use it on mule deer. I'm walking towards a tree stand here, and in front of that tree stand oftentimes you will find a carcass, because there's a lot of elk here. So there's the first call from a male. You can use the bugle caller. And we now know it's a group. It's multiple animals. A male and a female have already called. So the bugle caller works the same way for Rocky Mountain Elk and Roosevelt Elk. It will always attract them, and many times it'll trigger a response, a vocal response, as we've heard. There's also another caller that you can use, which is the wolf caller. It's mimicking an elk calf. And maybe a female will respond. Maybe. There's no guarantee that they will come, but this is basically appealing to the mother instinct of a female elk. When you use this caller, sometimes they respond. If there is a group of multiple females, the chances are fairly high that they will come. If one comes, all will come. Third track, or a call from the third different animal. So I now know there's at least two females. Let's try this again. No vocal response. Oh, there is. Okay. I find hunting here in Timbergold Trails relatively hard, because there's not too many thick trees, very few rocks, and also high grass. So oftentimes your sight is blocked. There can be a lot of bushes and stuff in your way, but the animals will see through this. So for example, this bush up ahead, this green bush, I cannot see through this, but the animals will see me. So this makes it a bit harder here to hunt. First female is coming in. The Rocky Mountain Elk are lighter by quite a bit, less heavy than the Roosevelt Elk. Especially the males are quite a difference. Roosevelt can get up to 500 kilograms. A but here the male can only get up to like 340. And I'm hoping for the male to show up. You can shoot cows with the bow when you drop them on the spot. Other cows will not spook, but males will. The bulls will spook from a bow shot from 50 meters away. So if I shot her, no matter whether she dropped or not, the bull would run just by the sound. 50 meters is what I've seen. She's trotting away, no longer alert. And so does she. All right, we want to see that bull. Oh, there's another. Pretty close now. Now I'm in the sandwich here. And I should use scent eliminator. I don't think I will see both bulls now. I think what I will do is actually use the bow on this one. There's the bull. And hope that the others don't run, which is the case. You can see the cow is really close. Well, not likely see, but you can hear it. She's right here. And did not spook. And we can only assume the other bull is more than 50 meters away. I'm not well protected, just partially Boone and Crockett. And the other bull just never shows up. But we have a lot of cows around us. So it looks like we're assembling two herds here. So, quite busy right here at the beginning. But we've got two bow kills. There she is. But why don't we go after this bull that called that we didn't see? Just for fun. And here is our first dead bull. Not a high scoring one, but you would see many racks like this or larger, which makes them really fun to hunt. .330 is a really good score for Roosevelt, and it's an average score for Rocky Mountain Elk, even though they're all smaller. They can easily score above 400. So when you shoot a Rocky Mountain Elk over 400, it's not quite as special as a Roosevelt Elk with the same score. Never saw the bull, not sure how far he actually came over this hill. But it's a busy place. I've lured two herds from two different sites. And at least I could shoot two of them. We got a wolf calling. Single wolf. Here we have the track from the bull. You see it's 310 to 340. And oftentimes it'll say that or 315 to 340. Here's another cow. So my tracking level is at 20 now. And even though this is the best level you can have, the estimation of the elk bulls is always 310 to 340 or 315 to 340, which makes it really hard. If you have a Roosevelt elk and you know it's a lightweight, it's not worth going after. So you can drop them, you can just go after bulls that go up to 500 kilograms. With the Rocky Mountain elk, you really have to go after every single one. You never know whether it might or might not be a good one. Of course, the weight does not guarantee a good score, but it's a good start. A low weight will never score high. There's another elk in the very back behind the trees. I don't know where my bull went to. But I've been looking at this cow here. She's feeding. What's really cool is there's a lot of different combinations in the groups of elk. With the Roosevelt, it's always the five or six cows. Now it's sometimes seven. But whatever number it is, it's always those groups. And then sometimes there can be a bull alongside in Red Feather Falls. There is never a bull in White Hart Island or Settler Creeks. You just know that. But here, you cannot know what's coming. So let's try the wolf caller, actually. Maybe a wolf's gonna run on top of me here. But let's see if she's coming. She responds. If you use this long hold, you have to be really close or it'll run. Most animals will run away. We'll make some noise now. And as you see, even from less than 10 meters, probably. Body shot. So the colt is quite a challenge. But of course she will die. And I guess we can forget the bull now. But there's plenty of elk here. Going further down southeast, you can see coming up on the map on the Hunter Mate, there's a tent and a tower. Been luring wolves there and elk as well, but somehow the wolves have disappeared for the most part. So now we're walking after an elk cow that was shot from 10 meters with a revolver. And she's still going. Oh, there she's bedding. And we have a third bow kill. Hard shot from close. So you see 8.4 meters was the first shot. And she didn't feel like dying. So I will turn around here, go east and then along the river up north. There's no point in crossing the river. Only elk that you spook over there will probably go there. Mule deer. So I'll turn away from this. Go to the left side of that lake, up that way, because there will now be mule deer calling down from the river. If I keep going north from here, there's a mountain starting, or I should say a hill. And you would think the elk will only be in the flat areas, but that's not the case. They will also go up and over these hills. And even up where the lodge is, you can go further west from there. There's still elk up there. But it's not quite the mountains yet. It's not the same as the area where the sheep are. Just higher areas. But still aspen trees or conifer trees. No grizzly so far, which is interesting. We must remember that the spawning numbers can be controlled right on the server. They don't need to make a patch or an update to change any of this. That's the wolf we had before. Single wolf, hunter mate recognizes the call. So let's see here. Let's call him down here, see if he comes. Usually they don't if they're just alone. And we might attract elk as well. So I'll go up here. There's a nice hill up ahead. Perfect for waiting. I'll wait there for a minute or two and then I'll move on. What you will see, by the way, is chasing scenes. You will see wolves running after elk. It's quite interesting. You see that often. Hopefully we'll see something like this here as well. And they will run after elk, but they will not actually kill an elk in the game. All the dead elk are placed when you start the hunt, and the wolves will go there eventually and feed from them. So this is simulating chasing situations, but you will not see wolves killing an elk in front of your eyes. This hill is perfect. We're protected from the side where the wolf might or might not come. And then we might see it down here. And the wolf has come. Now I have to change weapons here. It's a good weapon for multiple shots, for multiple wolves. but not very strong. So I usually shoot them twice. And of course any mule or elk will have run now. But at least we have a wolf on the side. First shot was liver, it will have died from it anyway. And then the second shot made sure it's not gonna go far. 16.45 is a good score. Let's change around this again. So far we haven't shot the classic rifle. So lots of noise, shooting and running. But now I will go up towards that hill and look for elk. Slightly going east as well, because there's more openings over there. This is another elk cow that has come close. Could have been following the call, I don't know. And just walking here is just beautiful with the colors, with the ambient sounds. Birds tweeting. Or singing, whatever they do. Would have been pretty cool if they had added snowfall as well, not just rain. And as far as the groups, same goes for mule deer, not just the elk, that you have a lot of variety in their combinations with males and females in any numbers, females up to 5, males maybe 2 or 3, they can mingle in any numbers. Whereas we know on Logger's Point, it's males or females, but never mixed groups. Females are always 5 or 6. So that's a bit boring. When I did my first hunts here for the complete guide of Timbergold Trails, I never saw the 5 brothers, so the 5 mule deer together. But then they released the map to life, actually, and there's a lot of times you will find them in groups of 5, which is really cool. And we have a wolf responding to the bugle caller, which is pure coincidence. Just called after me. And now I'm tempted to call this one up here as well. But I'm a bit missing all the packs. A lot of single wolves. Or I should say, if I find wolves, a lot of times they are single wolves. There's not a lot of them. I will leave it alone. Let's focus on the elk. So the wolf came in where I called it, howled, and kept trotting forward. I had to be fast. I was lucky to still be able to shoot it there. It could have been already disappeared from the speed it was coming in and leaving. What's happening here is when the wolves are about chasing elk, the elk will be nervous. They will trot around. They will not call, of course. Nervous animals don't call. So this makes elk hunting a bit more difficult. Sometimes you see elk coming towards you when you alert them. And then all of a sudden they start running away. Then you can know the wolves are about. Mule deer calling. I'll have to take her out or she will just keep calling. This is, by the way, the deer grunt call carved wood. It's the very same effect as the normal grunt call. This one is the special edition that you're getting when you recruit a friend. Sounds a bit weird, but it's gonna attract the mule deer just nicely. As always, I'm moving forward towards the animal. Even if I spooked her, so what? She will stop calling for a while, but it's better to really take her out. And now I'm attracting more. There she is. Bad shot. Now all the real life hunters, close your eyes and ears for 10 seconds. And for everybody else, I will just let her run. She's gonna die somewhere, but she's not gonna call again. I will keep focusing on the elk. Welcome back, real life hunters. Thanks for closing your ears. I just collected the mule deer. Elk moving south. More of them. Half an hour away. Coming up in the upper corner here, there's a tent and a double tree stand. And the icon is like a double tree. And exactly at this tent, I decided to start a new hunt. I would like to find one more nice bull. Shoot shooting with the classic rifle here. We've used the bow, the revolver, and also the semi-auto on the wolf. And now finally, looking for a bull or the rifle. There's lots of mule deer in this area. So first call coming from elk or mule deer would be to be expected, but there's a bull right here. This is pretty cool. So let's see what's coming. How far is my tree stand? I have been walking and the bull didn't spook. I will go right back to my tree stand. One thing I haven't mentioned, and this is true for both Rocky Mountain and Roosevelt Elk, you need to call them more often than, for example, mule deer or whitetail. Well, if we remember the first elk that we lured, after a while they ran away. Only a couple of minutes they're attracted and then they leave. So here we might get in trouble with the wind. Do we have some leaves? Falling. This is where they go. So we're just upwind of the elk. I will use some scent eliminator again. And here they come, although it's not the big bull I was envisioning. But quite honestly, I'm not surprised. Because I was walking and he was fairly close, still calling. So let's try the rifle then. There goes the bull. But this is a rather small one. You don't see those very often. Bullseye, I would say. All right. So the rifle is really powerful. You can really depend on those classic rifles, even though they're old, they have difficult reticles, they have no zoom in their scopes. They're pretty good rifles, find them always strong. And of course I would like to shoot one more that has really a nice big rack. Nice. Right over here. Another small one. Let's see if there's another. All right. All right, let's go see what we hit. There's another male. And this time it didn't say 340. For once it said the upper limit is 330. Long shot. And we have another bull, but it's again a really small one, 180 maybe, 181. All right. Still hoping for the big guy. We'll try one more. The next one is the last, whatever it is going to be. Bear coming right at us. I hit the forehead and it's still running. And we'll do one more. Single wolf ahead. I think I see it. Well, now this is getting busy. See. So this bear, I hit the forehead off and it kept going. I'll have to switch weapons back. And I fear the wolf is going to live. The semi-auto is not quite known for the killer machine. I've hit wolves from really close and they survived. Wolf fleeing. And I didn't hit it, it seems. But we have an elk. So here we hit it, intestines. That means it'll die after all. I think I see it already. Yes, dead wolf. But let's not spoil the elk bull. There it is. Oh, nice. At least in the upper 300. This one is. So this is our target to conclude this second short hunt. Comes our bull. Very nice rack, nice looking. But in the end, it's again the crown tines. One crown tine on each beam. And probably too narrow of a rack is where this one is losing the points. But who cares? We've got another bull, and along with the ones we've shot and the track from the fleeing, this would be the fourth bull in the area here. Not sure where he's trying to cross the river. But he will not cross any rivers anymore. And here is our last bull. Let's pretend we do a trophy shot with this, just to show the nice rack, which we haven't really done so far. And here we go, the nice looking rack of the Rocky Mountain Elk. I hope you liked this video, and I'll see you next time. I hope you enjoyed, never got annoyed. Thank you very much. Stay in touch.